more than 50% of the questions asked for PSC exams are asked in the previous question papers. That's why it is better to discuss, or it is better to go through the previous question papers. And about 40% of the questions are asked from the GK before. That's why we can skip GK questions. Question number 26. Ascorbic acid is the chemical name of. Option A, vitamin A. Option B, vitamin B. Option C is vitamin C. And option D, vitamin D. The answer is option C, vitamin C. We can just see all the names of other vitamins also. Vitamin A is otherwise known as retinol, and it is the anti-infective vitamin, because vitamin A is able to produce antibodies and thereby fight against infections. That's why it is known as anti-infective vitamin. This question also asked in previous questions. Then vitamin B is known as thiamine. Vitamin B2 is riboflavin. Vitamin B3 is niacin. Vitamin B5, pantothenic acid. Vitamin B6 is pyridoxine. Vitamin B8 is biotin, otherwise known as vitamin H. Vitamin B9 is folic acid, and it is otherwise known as vitamin M. Vitamin B12 is cobalamin. Vitamin C is ascorbic acid. It's also known as healing vitamin. It helps in healing, wound healing. And vitamin D is calciferol. Vitamin E, tocopherol, and also known as anti-aging vitamin. Vitamin K, phylloquinone or menadione. It is an essential vitamin for blood clotting. Question number 27. Hemoglobin is a coordination compound in which the central metal ion atom is option A, sodium, option B, magnesium, option C, manganese, and option D, iron. Answer is option D, iron. We can just see about the content of oxygen and iron carried by hemoglobin. 1 gram hemoglobin contains 3.4 mg iron per gram. This one also asked before, how much mg of iron is carried by 1 gram of hemoglobin. That's why for a normal adult male with 15 gram Hb per 100 ml can carry 50 mg iron, and also 1 gram Hb carry 1.34 ml of oxygen. This one also asked before in one exam question paper. Ask 1 gram Hb carry 1.34 ml oxygen, and that's why a man with 15 Hb can carry 20 ml of oxygen. Next question, question number 37, which is a widely used diagnostic test for AIDS. Option A, biopsy. Option B, X-ray. Option C, Vidal test. And option D, ELISA. The widely used diagnostic test for AIDS is option D, ELISA. ELISA is the widely used test to detect HIV infection. It is widely used for a large population. But once the ELISA is found to be positive, then Western blot test is used as a confirmatory test for HIV. Question number 39. Name an important protein digesting enzyme present in the gastric juice of human being. option A trypsin, option B pepsin, option C chymotrypsin, option D aminopeptidase. The answer is option B, pepsin. And you can see the description. Trypsin is produced by pancreas in an inactive form as trypsinogen. These all enzymes helps in protein digestion, but trypsin is produced by pancreas. Here the question is the gastric protein digesting enzyme present in gastric juice. The pepsin. Pepsin is the major protein digesting enzyme present in gastric juice. That is the answer. Then chymotrypsinogen, also produced by pancreas and is activated by trypsin after proteolysis to chymotrypsin. Then aminopeptidase is produced by small intestine for protein digestion. Question number 41. The term nursing process was first used by option A Virginia Henderson, option B Lydia Hall, option C Dorothea Oram, and option D Florence Nightingale. And the answer is option B, Lydia Hall. Question number 42. The measurement of obstetrical conjugate is option A 8.5 cm, option B 9.5 cm, option C 10.5 cm, and option D 11.5 cm. And the answer is option C 10.5 cm. The obstetrical conjugate is the distance between middle point of sacral promontory and the middle point of pubic symphysis. It is the shortest diameter for the fetus to descend. This is the sacral promontory and this is the symphysis pubis. Middle part of sacral promontory to the middle of symphysis pubis. This is the smallest conjugate that the fetus to be for the fetus to use for descent, and it is 10.5 cm. And this is the diagonal conjugate from the sacral promontory to the lower part of symphysis pubis. It is 12 cm and it is the only conjugate that can be measured by pervaginal examination. And this is the true conjugate from measurement from sacral promontory to the upper part of symphysis pubis. It is 11 cm. Question number 43. The assessment finding indicating successful potassium replacement for treatment of hypokalemia. Options are increasing muscle tone, B decreasing serum glucose, option C improving vision, and option D increasing blood pressure. The answer is option A, increasing muscle strength. Hypokalemia can cause muscle weakness, cramps, twitching, and paralysis of muscles. That's why once we are giving potassium replacement treatment, the weakness will be, the weakened muscles will get strength back.